So Earth Day was this week, and to keep the good vibes rolling, I thought that I'd put together a watercolor video for you all. It's our first watercolor that we're doing together in the shelter in place. So I really hope you'll follow along. We're gonna paint these insect cards today. They're gonna be super cool and super easy, but we do have a few more supplies that we need to gather beforehand. So I want you to make sure that you have a piece of watercolor paper. You might have a pad like this at home that's been dropped off in your art care package, or some that we gave you before we left, before the shelter in place. So you're gonna grab one piece of paper. I want you to grab a pencil with an eraser. If you have a separate eraser, you can grab that too. I want you to grab a straight edge, so like a ruler or something straight. If you don't have a ruler, you can use a book or something like that. A pair of scissors. Be super careful with these, right? Ask your parents if you need help. And some pens, some markers that you can use to color at the end. Then I want you to grab a few different small objects that you can use for shapes. So like maybe at the bottom of a cup that you can trace if you need a circle. I also found some cool funky things around my house that I wanted to try out. So I have this kind of statue and I thought the bottom kind of looked like an oval, so I might try that. Or this weird kind of like horn shaped thing that I found. I'm gonna try tracing this as well for shapes later. And then of course, grab your watercolor set, your good brush, and a cup filled halfway with water and a paper towel. And I think that that is all we need, and we can go ahead and get started. Okay, see you in a second. So first things first, I'm going to take one piece of watercolor paper. And I'm gonna fold my paper very lightly in half just to help myself in finding the halfway point before I go in with my straight edge. Next, I'm gonna take my ruler or my straight edge, and I'm gonna draw a line halfway down the middle, hamburger style, and then hot dog style. And it doesn't have to be exactly halfway. I'm just trying to make it as close as I can, because in the end, I want to be able to cut out four cards that are roughly the same size. Next, I'm gonna take my scissors and carefully cut along the line so that I make my four cards. If you see pencil marks on your cards, go ahead and erase them. You'll see me doing this a lot later when I use my pencil for the different shapes as well. Okay, so I'm gonna take my first card and the first shape that I wanna trace, and lightly with my pencil, trace along the bottom edge of the shape onto the paper to make the bug's body. And the reason I do it lightly is because before I go in to paint, I'm gonna wanna erase it almost until I can't see it anymore so that it doesn't come through the paint. Now for the bug's head, I'm gonna draw this upside down U shape, and I'm gonna connect it with two points at the bottom. And this part I'm gonna do freehand, and I'm just gonna draw a shape that makes sense with what I've already drawn for the bug's body. You can see it very lightly here. And as I move through different cards, my bug's heads may start to look different, and it's okay if yours look different too. Get creative with it, have fun, and remember that you can always pause the video if you need more ideas.
I did before and had my share. It didn't lead nowhere.
these cards look so good. The next step is going to be going in to add the legs and the antenna with the marker. And this card still looks a little bit wet to me. You can see it kind of glistening there. And I really want to make sure that I don't mess any up, so I'm going to wait until this is fully dry before I go on to the next step. This is the fun part. Add your legs, add the antenna, make it funky, make it cool, and remember you can always pause the video if you need more ideas.